Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Very good morning to all of you. I am Dr. Aftab, representing Department of Sociology, Government Degree College, Shopian. So the topic today which we are having, this is related to sociology. As I have already mentioned, the subject is sociology. The topic for the discussion will be marriage. You know, when we are talking in terms of marriage, marriage is basically one of the social institutions of the society. Before discussing something about marriage, let me try to understand what are the social institutions and what are their functions. To have a briefing about the social institutions, I would like to mention that just like we are having an organism, an organism is made up of different parts. Same way, all these very parts, they are having different functions to perform. We are having an individual, and individual is having head, and individual is having arms, and individual is having body, and individual is having legs, and individual is having feet. Same way, when we'll be just comparing an individual with the society, we can say that the society is also made up of different parts. And those very parts are called family, marriage, kinship, religion, education, and polity, etc. As important the parts are having in human body, that much important we are having these very parts in society. But in society, these very parts are being entitled as social institutions. Just like our hand is having different function, our tongue is having different function, our legs are having different functions, and all other internal organs, they are having different functions to perform. Same way, within the society, all these very social institutions, they are having their particular function to perform. So, from this very perspective, we can say that the marriage, it is one of the social institutions of the society. Number one. Number second aspect about marriage is that this marriage is a universal social institution. Talking from this universality, it highlights that this universality means the marriage, it exists in every part of the society or every part of the world, although it can have diverse forms. But the question may be asked, if it is universal, but what exactly marriage is? Although you people may be aware of the fact that you might have heard marriage several times, but you may not be having exact knowledge that what marriage is all about. Generally highlighting the marriage, I will be giving you a briefing about the same. This marriage is basically a sex relationship between individuals. Usually those very individuals, they belong to opposite sex, means a sexual relationship between male and a female. But one more point is very much important, which you must know. This always is a sexual relationship, but this very sexual relationship should be socially approved. What is social approval? This may seem a new word to you, social approval. Social approval generally means that the marriage should be accepted by the individuals of the society. That is the main reason when you are talking in terms of it is social approval. This differentiates this kind of sexual relationship from all other sexual relationships which are being carried forward in brothels, which are being carried forward in prostitution centers. There is also the sexual relationship. But those very sexual relationships may be illegal. Those very sexual relationships are not recognized by the society. So one important aspect which you must know about marriage is that this is a sexual relationship, but that very sexual relationship should be socially approved, this should be socially accepted. Means the individuals of the society, they should accept the bonding between two individuals. Moving ahead, we can say that this relationship is generally a bond. This is a bond. As you might have heard, bond, sometimes we are giving it a reflection as union. So this is such a bond which binds two people together. Two strangers, they are just brought together by this very bond. Once they are getting bound through this very bond, it means that there will be the mutual obligations. mutual obligations of one individual on other individual. One individual will expect something from other individual, and other individual will expect something from the first individual. So there are mutual obligations which these very individuals are supposed to fulfill. One more point about the marriage is that it is devised by the society to regulate the sexual life or sexual relationship. This is a bond which is being designed by the society for regulation of sexual relationships. Apart from sexual relationships, some other aspects of the marriage which we are having are, after regulation of sexual relationship, it leads towards the reproduction. Means, whenever marriage occurs, there is one more aspect. This marriage, it gives rise to the offsprings. There is birth of offsprings. So, this marriage is an option as of which the individuals, they can go for procreation. Without marriage, the procreation is possible. I am not saying that procreation is not possible. Procreation is possible, but that very procreation may not be having social grounds. That may not be having the social basis. So, if you wish to have the legal children, then we need to have a bond which will be based on marriage. Apart from this, this marriage, it is conferring the husband and wife the social estimation to live together. Generally, what we are supposing that two unmarried persons, generally a male and a female, they can't live together. But there is the bond, that very bond is marriage. This marriage is giving them a permission that if you wish to live together, then you have to go for marriage. Without marriage, two separate individuals, especially if they are belonging to the opposite sex, they cannot live together. So marriage is having such an impact that two strangers who belong to two different families, it can get them together and will ask them that you can live together. Not only live together, they can have different kind of relationships, maybe the biological relationship, maybe the social relationship, and maybe they can go for the procreation. Looking from these very perspectives, we can say that this marriage, it is basically being consumed in order to have in order to fulfill the physical needs of the individuals. All the individuals, they may be having multiple needs. Their needs vary from physical, their needs are social, their needs are psychological. In order to fulfill all those very needs, we need to have marriage. Fine? So, going ahead, we are having some other parameters of this very marriage, which will be highlighted by going through some of its basic characteristics. So, I will be just reflecting upon the characteristics of marriage. The first characteristic of marriage is that it is a specific relationship. As you may be knowing, we are having different type of relationships. We are having friendship relationship, we are having brother-sister relationship, we are having father-daughter relationship, we are having son-mother relationship. But when you are talking in terms of marriage, this is specific relationship between husband and wife. This specific relationship, it is providing them the roles which you have to perform. A husband is having a particular role to perform towards the wife, and a wife is supposed to perform a particular role towards her husband. Number one. Number second is that this marriage, it requires a social approval. Unless and until the people will not accept the relationship of two persons, that may not be regarded as marriage. I will be quoting a simple example. If you are living within a society, there is a guy, there is a girl. They are having a very, let's say, they are of younger age. They got married. All the people, they will be just looking on them and they will not be posing finger on them. They will be accepting that we are witness to their marriage, and wherever they will go, nobody will be posing finger to them. If they will be changing their residence and they will go to some other location, but they seem very young. The people who will be living in that very society, they will be posing a finger. They will say, we don't know why they are living together. We have not seen their marriage. So they will be posing the question. It means making marriage a kind of legal bond, social approval is mandatory. So the social approval is being bestowed by the individuals who are witness to that type of marriage. Moving ahead, this marriage also is helpful to establish a family. establishment.